Hi, in this video, we will go over some of the questions that are in the exam one exercise, the review exercises for exam number one. And one of the questions is asking us to trace the execution of this production system. And for that, we want to show each one of the iterations. So for that question, it's asking us to show the iterations that we would see in a data-driven search. And the question also says that initially in working memory, we have the rule 6 is the beginning. So that means we have in the start M in working memory. So this is what it means. In the data-driven search, then on my initially, so we don't actually see that as kind of the interactions. We got the M, and then M comes from the rule 6, and this is the rule that is initially fire. So when we fire rule 6, which is M, what it means is this is substituted, this is a fact, this is true, then we're adding these three facts to working memory. So look, on this iteration, we got the M, and now we got these three. And now we got four facts, and we're looking for matches of this in the rules. And then you see, we got the M, which is the one for the 6, but then the V matches rule 5. So then we have now 6 and 5. And then we got an R and a Q. Here is an R. Here is an R, but there is no Q, so it has an R and a S to get the P, or R and a W to add the P. And then with the Q, we need the P, the Q by itself. So R and Q, there is nothing here, so we're not adding anything else. As soon as we get into the goal, then we stop, we halt. Okay, then the next rule. So this is what we have in the conflict set. So now we're going with this one, which is the one that was added last, and we're going to execute 5. So that was a match here. And then for 5, what it says is from B, now we're getting S. So we're adding S into the working memory. So on my next iteration, I got this. Now we look for matches for these rules, and then we know that these first three, these 1, 2, 3, 4, these first four that we did before, we got a 6 and a 5, right? So now let's see if something changes when we're adding that S. Let's look for rules that got an S. So we got an S here, but we need an R, and we got the R. So RS, this will include, this will have this added into the, this rule will be a match for what we have in the working memory. Then in my conflict set, now I'm adding 2. Let's see if this matches any other of the left-hand side of my production rules. And it sees that that's the only one, right? So this is the only one that has the S. This is the only one that will be new. Now the next rule that will be fire will be 2. So I look for 2 in my production system and see what happens when we do 2. So that is, now we will include me the P. So now I have P. So I got this in working memory. Haven't deleted anything that. And then I got the P. And then now we're gonna see these facts that we have, which one of these production rules. So we just add in the P, and the one that has the P is just number 1. And then number 1 needs a Q, a P and a Q, and I got the P in the Q. So we know that the ones before matches 6, 5, 2, and 9 matches 1. And there is nothing else that has a P. And the next rule that I will execute is 1. And then on my next iteration, WSP. And when we do one, we're adding the goal. And in this case, as soon as we reach the goal, then we halt, because this is what we're looking for. I mean, the working memory or whatever we have here is the goal. We're ready to make a conclusion or to finish with the problem. So we don't need this, and then I don't think goal even generates another, I mean, adds another fact, but this is actually what we were looking for. So then in this case, we say that we halt, and that will end the problem. Now, let's say that we were solving this problem. I mean, this concludes this exercise. But let's now assume that the question, instead of asking for the data-driven search, it was asking for the goal-driven search. So let's see what will be the difference. So let's have here. So just to practice, goal-driven search. So in this case, let's see what is the difference. So in the case of the data-driven, look at that we started with the data, with the facts there, and then we were matching these facts with other facts until we reach the goal. In the goal-driven, we will start then with the goal until we get to the beginning, so it's to the last possible rule that we can add and we can halt. So it's kind of like the inverse. So in this case, the first iteration, the difference is that we have now the goal, and then I forgot to label this. So this is the iteration. This is the working memory. You can see from here, but not on my. This is the conflict set. And this is the rule file. So I'm just having a table just like the one on top. Okay, so now goal is here. So this goal gets this, matches this. So in this case, this matches this facts. So now, and the goal in this case is the rule one, and this is the rule that is executed. And now we got, on the next iteration, we got goal and PQ. And for goal PQ, so we know the goal matches one. Now P gets 2 and 3, and the Q is number 4. So now look at that. In this approach, we're looking for matches on the right-hand side of the production, while here we were looking for matches in the working memory on the left-hand side. So now we got the P and the Q that is being added, and the matches that we got was 2, 3, and 4. And that's it, because this Q needs a V and an R. So there is a 2, 3, and a 4, right? Now, the next rule that is going to be fired from my set is number 2. That's the next one that will go there. So then on 2, we got then now adding the R and the S. So then we got a goal, the P and the Q, that we got that before. And then now we're adding R and S. And this is my second iteration. And now we're looking for what is it that this matches on the right-hand side of my production. So without the S, we knew it was 1, 2, 3, and 4. And now adding the S, this is the only one that has an S. So much is 5. So we're adding 5. And then the next rule that we're adding, that we're fighting, is 5. Then when we fire this rule, which is 5, we're adding the V. And so let's add that. I'm sorry, the rule that now we follow, here we did 2, right? So here we're doing 3, I'm sorry, this is 3. This is 3, sorry. So we're doing 3 here. I was looking at the last one, and this is the next one. So it's 3. So for 3 now, we're adding W and R. R is already in the set. So we got the goal, P, Q, R, S. Now we're adding W. And then we look for matches for this. And on the left hand side, and then it says nothing has a W, so it doesn't really make any changes. So this is then still the same conflict set 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 in this iteration. And then this is 3. And now the next rule that we're gonna fire from my conflict set is 4. And then let's see on 4. Then we're adding T and U. So then we got the goal, P, Q, R, S, W. And then we got the T and the U. This is 4. And then we know that these are the rules, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So by adding the T and the U, there is nothing that has the T and the U here, so it still doesn't change. I'm not adding anything to the conflict set. So then the next rule that we're executing now, it is 5. Now by doing 5, we're adding now the V there. So on the 5th iteration, I got this in my working memory. This is P, this is Q, R, S, W, T, U, and then the V. And then I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But now we're adding, let's see, we're adding the V. And then the only possible rule that has the V is this, but it is an R and a Q. And we had the R and the Q. So we can do 6. So we're adding 6. And this is actually the rule that is going to be 5. Then six. So we have here the goal, P, Q, R, S, W, T, U, V. And by doing 6, we're adding M, which is the start. And that doesn't add anything else with M, so is this the same conflict set? 4, 5, 6. And then M, so as soon as we get this, then we halt. That's it, so you can see